Hi everyone, and welcome back to another lesson on High School Science 101. Today we are talking about forces, but specifically friction, which is what we call a contact force because it involves physical contact between two surfaces, as opposed to a non-contact force which doesn't involve contact between things, like magnetism and gravity. When we think of friction, we often think of two surfaces rubbing together and generating heat. So kinetic energy, energy of movement, being converted into heat energy. And this is true, but this also applies when things are moving through liquids and gases. When something is moving through a liquid or a gas, that object is colliding with particles in that liquid or gas, and that kinetic energy that was pushing that object forward is being converted into heat energy and slowing that object down. And we call that drag, because it's dragging the object behind and slowing it down. Generally speaking, friction can be good or bad. In everyday life, it's pretty useful because, for example, the fingerprints on your hand and fingers give you just enough friction to be able to pick up pens and pencils and utensils without them slipping out of your hand. If it's been a really wet day and you're walking down the street, you're relying on friction between the bottom of your shoe and the ground to stop you from falling over. Where friction is not as useful and can even be quite costly is in things like machines and engines where you've got moving parts rubbing against each other all the time, and over time that wears them down and can lead to breakages. So we have to keep adding oil to engines to reduce that level of friction. Today I'm going to demonstrate two ways that we can increase the level of friction. The first way is to increase the amount of force between the two surfaces. So if you rub your hands together really lightly, it generates a little bit of friction and then a little bit of heat. But if you apply more force between your hands, it generates more heat because there's more friction. Let's do an experiment that not only demonstrates this, but measures it as well. Here I have a wooden block and a spring balance. And this spring balance allows me to measure the force required to drag this block along this desk. I'm going to connect this spring balance to the block of wood and then pull it along and measure how much force is required to pull the block in a unit called newtons. As I'm pulling the block, I can see that it takes about 0.75 newtons of force to pull this block. Now we're going to do the same thing, but add a 500 gram weight on top of the wood and then pull it. And so adding the weight increases the force between the two surfaces. Sure enough, after adding the 500 gram weight, it now takes 2.5 newtons of force to pull the block. The next step is to add another 500 gram weight, and when we pull that along, we can now see that it takes 4 newtons of force to pull the block of wood. As we've demonstrated, it takes more effort to pull the block of wood when it has more weight added to it, and that's because that weight is adding more force between the two surfaces and increasing that amount of friction, making it harder to pull. Another factor that influences the amount of friction is the type of surface. A smooth surface lets things glide very easily along it, whereas a lot of energy is wasted traveling on a rough surface because of the increased amount of friction. To demonstrate this, we are using our block of wood again, and our spring balance, and a 500 gram weight. And we'll pull this block along a smooth surface, this desk, and also a rough surface, which is this felt. So firstly, pulling this block along the smooth surface takes about 2 newtons of force. Let's set this up now on our rough surface, our felt, and we can see that now it takes about 7 newtons of force to pull it, which is a lot more force than what was required on our smooth surface, and that's because the rough surface is providing that increased amount of friction. And that's it for today. I've given you a bit of an overview as to what friction is, and also we've looked at how we can increase friction through adding more force to the different surfaces or changing the type of surfaces themselves. Thanks for watching, and thank you so much for all of your support so far. All of your likes and comments are very much appreciated, and they've helped this channel become an official YouTube partner, which I'm really excited about. So thanks again, and I'll see you next time.